Hello and welcome back to Black Craft Reviews. I'm your host Christina. We're back to discuss Rick and Morty, episode 7 of season 7, if I'm correct, entitled Wet Quot Amorton Summer.
What the fuck is this shit?
Written by Alex Song Sia and directed by Ki-young Gi Lim. I think I probably missed a lot of the reference in this movie. There was only Taken that I got, but I have a feeling this was a spin on some other type of series or movie that I'm just not familiar with. I don't know what quattos are or what they're associated with. I didn't laugh quite as much as I did previously. The storyline was just kind of meh. My favorite scene was Rick going around punching people saying, "Where is she? Where is she?" And that referencing Taken, I thought that was pretty funny.
I will look for you. I will find you. And I will kill you.
I do think there was a message in there around the idea of, you know, sometimes if you're someone that warrants respect, you're going to treat them more like an adult. And they are going to earn things. And sometimes you have those like Morty who doesn't get a lot of the things that he wants because he doesn't put in the work to earn those things. But they both have the same desire, which is to be popular or considered popular, which is every teenager's I'm coming to understand the full scope of their existence from the time they turn around 12 until, well, whenever they may realize that they'll meet the right people when it happens. I don't know. Some people don't grow out of that mindset. But because they're children, I'm far more lenient towards their adolescent need to be accepted. We begin the episode with Summer doing chores. It's because she wants to get this gadget that's going to increase her charisma. It's going to change her genetic stats to fit the situation at this falafel party, which is apparently frisbee and golf.
What kind of bullshit is this?
Of course, this is the same group of high school friends that have already partied with Grandpa and went on one of his space adventures, even though I thought they erased everybody's memory, but I could be mistaken. When they get to the party, Morty gets jealous and decides to ruin everything for Summer. And I gotta say, Morty was kind of being a little bitch because she really did put in the work to earn that. And you did absolutely nothing besides beg your grandpa. And he causes her to be grossly transformed, but highly intelligent, and steals the device for himself to give him abs. Because he wants to have sex with her best friend.
Boy, if you don't get...
causing them to fight, falling into the pool. And now they're fused together and Morty is a quato. They're both shamed for what has happened. Even on social media, it was like from this to that. And when she goes home to tell Grandpa what has happened, he says, "Well, you have to earn the privilege of undoing your mistake. Because, unfortunately, I don't know, though, I feel as if Morty kind of got off a little easy, because he's the one that fucked shit up because of his jealousy. If he would have just stayed in his lane, then and pouted and just took his shit on the shoulder, then she has to do the chores to fix the situation that she didn't break in the first place. I'm kind of with Summer. If you would have fixed it, then this would have not gotten out of control as far as it did. And him saying, oh, it's because I respect you. Yeah, that may have been the initial, but after the fact, I don't know. I feel as if Morty should have been the one doing the chores. But I digress. Summer sees this club where Quados are accepted, and because that's what she wants more than anything in the world, she goes there, says, fuck the chores. Rick went down there and said, you let them get hungry? And then she meets she meets Quiet, who introduces her to Kenneth, who looks like some type of faux Jesus Christ figure. Everyone got Quados, and everyone is super cool on this planet for it. She starts to get close with Quiet, but it's all a setup so that they can steal her Quado, which is Morty, her brother, and sell him to the highest bidder. So now she has to go find him. I love the one scene where she saved the one chick, but she's like, I need to save my brother, so I can't save you any more than I already did. That was pretty funny. And then she too starts to beat the shit out of Quiet to find out where her brother is, because they have surgically removed him from her, which is rather fucked up. And it comes to find out that there's a psychic connection between the Quado. All this time that he was saying, open your mind, he was trying to communicate with her, and she didn't understand or even think to utilize the superpowers, which made a Quado amazing. And that's how she's able to track down Summer with Morty's help. Not Morty's help, with Rick's help, who finally gets there where he's like, where is she? Right behind you. And then they go and rescue him from Kenneth. He dies, but after he is revealed to be a Quado controlling the host instead of the host controlling the Quado. Morty really wants that chair. So they murder him because they was tired of him busting out more objects that were Quados of itself, and just watch him being drowned with Morty being like, I really wanted that chair. So they're like, yeah, I'll get you the chair. And that's how he's able to play Floffle. I'm probably saying that wrong, but I don't really care to say it right, because that's the dumbest thing I've ever heard in my life. But yeah, Morty does get off easy because he's akin to a pet. Beth tried to roll up on Grandpa and got lasered. Luckily, she used some tongs. She's like, where's Summer? Where's my children? I'll find them. They're doing chores. It's all good. Then the minute he saw the license plate and that she was taken, it was on. So that was the only bit that really tickled me. For the most part, it was okay. Not one of my favorites. And in the end, it kind of ended like an 80s movie with everyone cheering them on, even though they were just booing them 5 seconds ago. And they're not bothered by this at all. Even though she does blow off the one guy and says, yeah, I'm kind of badass. I need to stop wasting my time on people that are subpar. And I'm like, yeah, you do that. And is that our first indication that, well, I think we've been known that Summer, I think the whole entire family for that matter, swings every which away. We can never forget about the dragons. Percocet, yeah, Molly Percocet, be it fine. Percocet, yeah, Molly Percocet, be it fine. Represent, yeah, gotta represent. I'm glad I never really had to worry about peer pressure in high school. I was so disconnected from everyone. It wasn't like I was ever going to a party. Like, that boggles my mind that kids just go to parties. Like, the fuck? Unless it's a school function, I think not. That is not something that happens. That's my whole shock of Euphoria and all those shows like it. 13 Reasons Why Teenagers Just Out in the Streets. Nope. Not on my watch. I will say I love the after credit scenes when we find out that it's the Squid Game. Those rich guys that want to buy the Quado, like they're waiting for it. And there's this guy that he's got his legs on top of. Because of course it would be the extremely rich that would want something that would have them even more enslaved to them, another person that you're psychically connected to. Yeah. And the one dude's like, you have a wife? We don't care about anything personal. We're dedicated to our slovenry. Is that the correct word? Oh, rich people, man. Rich people. Of course, they would want this type of commodity because that is, we're finding out the world we live in, that they just have a whole different kink. We do have feedback, so let's hop into the mailbag.
Hey Christina, it's me, Shy. I am here to give my feedback for Rick and Morty, episode 7 of season 7. I really enjoyed this episode. I gotta hurry up and give my feedback now that this thing is acting a fool again. And the file is too big after a certain amount of time. But yes, like I said, I enjoyed this one. I usually enjoy the episodes when it's the three of them, Rick, Morty, and Summer, because I love Rick and Morty's dynamic, of course, then Summer and Rick, and then Summer and Morty's, and then the three of them together. So this was, you know, one of those episodes, and again, I enjoyed it. This one, I will say, you know, with the topic, I was just talking to some friends the other day about, you know, rich people and the fact that I think we were talking about this a bit on a podcast too, about rich people when they have too much time and too much money on their hands and how they tend to, their moral compass tend to be messed up after a while. And of course, in lieu of the recent events with P. Diddy, and others, but him being the recent one, it's just like, y'all, I just don't understand this thought process. I mean, I do understand it, but it's just crazy to me. Let me just put it that way, because I do understand it. This thought process, you know, it's like, why do you think you're gonna get away with this stuff? I mean, that's always my first thought. It's like, yeah, you're gonna get away. You may get away, and I tell my kids this all the time. You may get away with it, you know, momentarily, like the first time, second time. Hell, you might get away with it 20 times, but you continue doing this behavior, or you, even if you stop, especially the more people that know, the greater your chances are of getting caught eventually. And it's like, because there's no honor among thieves. There's no loyalty when you're doing that type of shit. It's like, who do you really trust? And of course, you know, it's one of those things where you're like, well, we're all in it together. We're all doing this fucked up shit together. So of course they're not gonna tell on me. But it's always somebody, and then it just snowballs from there. So this one reminded me of that with them like cutting up the quads, and of course I got the Total Recall reference this time, so I was happy. But anyway, but it's like there's a market for, it seems like every fucking thing there's a market so for it. And in this case, here we got this. And so it was just one of those kind of interesting that I'm watching this as this more recent news event has unfolded. And yes, it's just crazy to me. The stuff that these people with too much money on their hands end up doing, again, like, where is your moral compass? Where's your humanity? It just goes away, or is compromised in some form or fashion. So that's the biggest thing I want to take away I have from this episode. Obviously, it was funny to me because I said I enjoyed it. But outside of that, that's the biggest takeaway. So I'm going to leave it at that because I don't know how long these things need to be in order to be sent. These files need to be in order to be sent, so I'm not going to take any chances. Until next time, much love, peace, and Black Girl Magic, Queen of the Couch, Shy.
Thank you, Queen Shy, with your thoughts on the episode. Sounds like you liked it a lot more than I did. I didn't give my score, so I gave it a 6.9 out of 10. I think the Total Recall reference is lost on me. It's been a long time since I saw that movie, but I'm glad to know what it was from. As far as, you know, the Diddy situation, rich people not having a moral compass, I don't know. Did you watch The Fall of the House of Usher? I'm not sure if you watched that show. I can't remember right now if you were sending feedback on that show. But, yeah, it's this idea that once you're, and I watch a lot of documentaries, too, on, you know, I do. Of course I do, because I love every rabbit hole that can ever be a rabbit hole. But I do think that when we're trying to rationalize why people do things, we can't do it. We can't conceptualize because we're not those people. We don't know what it is to have that life. And not just on the easy negative side of it, right? The inflation of ego, the egomaniacs, the just perversions of society, because once you acquire so much, then what becomes worthy, what becomes tantalizing in life? So all of those things are questions that we just can't ever answer, because we're never going to be in that mindset to know. They don't consider a moral code. That's not, no. Once you start living a certain, I think a certain life of luxury, you disassociate from everything that was before. And it's maybe not everyone, clearly. And I think it depends on how close you are to people in your circle, you know, what your life was before you had all that money, so on and so forth. Those are all things that are going to play a huge role in whether or not, especially if you become a Black billionaire the way in which Diddy was. But I don't feel as if Diddy, that shit, at least for me, wasn't surprising. Not at all. That bitch was the biggest, on the Oscars. Oh my goodness, I had so many words for how he was playing his role that night. So no, I'm not, I feel like this is kind of a been new, but everybody's finally coming. It's like the same thing with R. Kelly. Everybody knew that he was a child molester. I mean, he came out with that shit with Aaliyah like when she was 15. He tried to marry her. I mean, we knew all of this. Like, we know some of the dirt before the dirt be getting, like, everyone else is caught up to it. So I feel like while it's shocking, it's more like shocking he got caught. It's shocking that they finally bringing him out of the dark into the light, into justice. But the shit that he would do, no. I mean, it's been swirling. These rumors, like I said, some rumors, yeah, they may be rumors, but if they're rumors for a long time, like decades fucking long, there's something to those rumors. So when there's confirmation, we're like, woo, that's finally come to light. I didn't think to that level. No, I wouldn't have imagined to that level. But once again, I am really not shocked after finally coming to some knowledge about what it means to be in that type of lifestyle, that these people live in an existence that simply is not our concept of reality. And so, yeah, they're gonna do shit like this. And that's where I'm going to leave it. If you want to send feedback, LikerCouch@gmail.com, or you can leave a comment below. My social media will be there as well. Like, share, subscribe. Until the next time, peace, hair grease, and blacker magic.